Good morning. Good morning. Welcome back to Coffee and the Word. It's 6:46 on a Saturday morning. Looks like we're going to be getting rain all day, and I've still got bedhead, but oh well. Oh, that's good. I'm having the taste of San Antonio this morning, and this is one of my dad's cups. And it's got this hairline crack in it, about that long, but it doesn't leak or anything, and I just keep using it. Oh, I like that one. All right. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's go to Saturday's readings. You open up the calendar, click the link. Takes you to the readings. All right. It's the same psalmody this morning, Psalm 89, verses 1 through 4, and then 19 through 26, and then we're going to go to Judges, and then we're going to go to the Gospel of John. And once again, we're in the English Standard Version. So here we go, Psalm 89, verses 1 through 4, and then 19 through 26. And as always, may God bless the reading of His Word. And let me get a little coffee here. Good news for this is pertaining to Joy Lutheran Church. A new pastor and his wife got moved into their house, so that's a good thing, and so we're certainly happy for them. So here we go. Psalm 89, verses 1 through 4. I will sing of the steadfast love of the Lord forever. With my mouth I will make known your faithfulness to all generations. For I said, steadfast love will be built up forever. In the heavens you will establish your faithfulness. You have said, I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David my servant. I will establish your offspring forever and build your throne for all generations. And then 19 through 26. Of old you spoke in a vision to your godly one and said, I have granted help to one who is mighty. I have exalted one chosen from the people. I have found David my servant. With my holy oil I have anointed him, so that my hand shall be established with him. My arm also shall strengthen him. The enemy shall not outwit him. The wicked shall not humble him. I will crush his foes before him and strike down those who hate him. My faithfulness and my steadfast love shall be with him, and in my name shall his horn be exalted. I will set his hand on the sea and his right hand on the rivers. He shall cry to me, you are my Father, my God, and the rock of my salvation. Excuse me. Just now getting up. All right, now we're going to Judges. We're in Judges 13, verses 2 through 24. So this one's a long one, so that's all good. So here we go. There was a certain man of Zorah, of the tribe of the Danites, whose name was Manoah, and his wife was barren and had no children. And the angel of the Lord appeared to the woman and said to her, behold, you are barren and have not borne children, but you shall conceive and bear a son. Therefore, be careful and drink no wine or strong drink, and eat nothing unclean. For behold, you shall conceive and bear a son. No razor shall come upon his head, for the child shall be called a Nazarite to God from the womb, and he shall begin to save Israel from the hand of the Philistines. Then the woman came and told her husband, a man of God came to me, and his appearance was like the appearance of an angel of God, very awesome. I did not ask him where he was from, and he did not tell me his name. But he said to me, behold, you shall conceive and bear a son. So then, drink no wine or strong drink, and eat nothing unclean, for the child shall be a Nazarite to God from the womb to the day of his death. Then Manoah prayed to the Lord and said, O Lord, please let the man of God, whom you sent, come again to us and teach us what we are to do with the child who will be born. And God listened to the voice of Manoah, and the angel of God came again to the woman, and she sat as she sat in the field. But Manoah, her husband, was not with her. So the woman ran quickly and told her husband, "Behold, the man who came to me the other day has appeared to me." And Manoah arose and went after his wife and came to the man and said to him, "Are you the man who spoke to this woman?" And he said, "I am." And Manoah said, "Now when your words come true, what is to be the child's manner of life, and what is his mission?" And the angel of the Lord said to Manoah, "Of all that I said to the woman, let her be careful. She may not eat of anything that comes from the vine, neither let her drink wine or strong drink, or eat any unclean thing. All that I command her, let her observe." And Manoah said to the angel of the Lord, "Please, let us detain you and prepare a young goat for you." And the angel of the Lord said to Manoah, "If you detain me, I will not eat your food. But if you prepare a burnt offering, then offer it to the Lord." For Manoah did not know that he was an angel of the Lord. And Manoah said to the angel of the Lord, "What is your name, so that when your words come true, we may honor you?" And the angel said to him, "Why do you ask my name, seeing it is wonderful?" So Manoah took the young goat and the grain offering and offered it on the rock to the Lord, to the one who works wonders. And Manoah and his wife were watching. And when the flame went up towards heaven from the altar, the angel of the Lord went up in the flames of the altar. Now Manoah and his wife were watching, and they fell on their faces to the ground. The angel of the Lord appeared no more to Manoah and to his wife. Then Manoah knew that he was an angel of the Lord. And Manoah said to his wife, "We shall surely die, for we have seen God." But his wife said to him, "If the Lord had meant to kill us, he would not have accepted a burnt offering and a grain offering at our hands, or shown us all these things, or now announced to us announced to us such things as these." And the woman bore a son, and called his name Samson. And the young man grew, and the Lord blessed him.
All right. Oh, goodness. All right, the New Testament lesson this morning. We're in the Gospel of John, chapter 7, verses 40 through 52. So here we go. "And when they heard these words, some of the people said, 'This really is the prophet.' Others said, 'This is the Christ.' But some said, 'Is the Christ to come from Galilee? Has not the scripture said that the Christ comes from the offspring of David and comes from Bethlehem, the village where David was?' So there was a division among the people over him. Some of them wanted to arrest him, but no one laid hands on him. The officers then came to the chief priests and Pharisees, who said to them, 'Why did you not bring him?' The officers answered, 'No one ever spoke like this man.' And the Pharisees answered them, 'Have you also been deceived? Have any of the authorities of the Pharisees believed in him? But this crowd that does not know the law is accursed.' Nicodemus, who had gone to him before and who was one of them, said to them, 'Does our law judge a man without first giving him a hearing or learning what he does?' And they replied, 'Are you from Galilee too? Search and see that no prophet arises from Galilee.'" And this is the word of the Lord. All right, I'd like to read from this one again. And see, we're in Saturday of Advent 3. It says, "You shall have no other gods." And what does this mean? It's, we should fear, love, and trust in God above all things. And what does God require of us in the first commandment? And what difference
should this commandment make in our lives? Well, Psalm 118:8, it is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. Proverbs 3:5, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. And some biblical examples is David trusted in the Lord when he fought against Goliath, and Abram left his country and relatives to go where the Lord sent him, trusting that the Lord would take care of him. And again, Daniel committed himself to the Lord's keeping. He says, we believe that God requires that we fear, love, and trust in Him above all things. We trust in God above all things when we commit our lives completely to His keeping and rely on Him for help in every need. Let us pray. I thank You, dear Lord, for Your infinite mercy, that You reached out to me, a lost person, in such a fatherly way. I did not ask for, seek, or deserve this, but You offered to be my God and will accept me. You will be my comfort, help, protection, and strength in every time of need. Although we poor, blind creatures have sought many gods elsewhere and would still have to seek them, if You had not openly made Yourself known and presented Yourself to us as our God, who in all eternity could thank You enough for this blessing. Amen. Absolutely. Isn't that just the truth? And, I see all these things on social media. You know, I accept Jesus Christ as my Lord. I accept. And I heard someone say, I mean, can you really go to the Almighty and say, I accept You? That just, to me, that language, and I get the sentiment behind it and everything, but to me that language seems a little off. It should be us just getting on our knees and begging to be accepted by Him. And that's called repentance. Anyway, there's my little soapbox for the day. So anyway, you guys have a great weekend. I am off for the next 2 weeks, so I'll still be doing this. And I thoroughly enjoy doing this, so I look forward to it every day. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and sign off. And y'all have a great day. So with that, be safe, be happy, and be blessed. And we'll see you tomorrow on Coffee and the Word. God bless.